When drawing a character, it can help if you break it down into smaller sections and shapes. So let's give it a try with Finn from Adventure Time. First of all, we need a case. Not a suitcase, a pillowcase. Draw the outline of the pillow. Then add the two pointed corners. Clean up the lines, leaving just a little overlap on each side. What's next? An egg. But we need to tip it on its side at the top of the pillow. This will be the face hole in Finn's hood. Using the middle of the shape as the guideline, add his smiling mouth. Then add his two eyes, the tops of his smile pointing at them. Then add the line of his hood. Kidney beans. Chili. And also good for the straps of his backpack. Add them on each side of his body, just overlapping the bottom line of his hood. String can be used for the arms and legs. His arms are drawn from the middle of the straps on both sides. Add three fingers on each hand. His legs are the same length as his body, so measure out the body, and then the same again beneath. The legs are drawn on the same line as the edge of his body, like this. A couple of jelly beans will work for the feet. But what about the tops of his boots? Take a bagel or a donut with a hole in the middle. These will go where his ankles would be. Here and here. Then add the middle hole lines. Add a line on each arm for his sleeves and on each strap of his backpack. Then he needs some shorts. First add the waistline, then add each short leg just a little wider than each leg on the inside. Clean up all the unwanted lines. And there we have Finn, ready to join Jake on whatever quest comes along. When we design characters, we do so with shapes and objects from the world around us. So it makes sense that spotting shapes within existing characters can help us when we draw. Take a mouse. No, not a real mouse. A mouse for your computer. That's better. That could be Jake's body. So let's draw around that. What about his eyes? Well, I think he has two cute little button eyes. So I'm going to use these ones. Then I'm going to add slightly thicker edges around the left and right eyes. Perfect. Now take a horseshoe. Actually, you'd better imagine one. Position it like this, and that kind of looks like the jowl around his nose, right? OK, so I'm going to draw that in. Now take an egg. And shade that shape in for his nose. For the mouth, excuse me, miss, a croissant.
Give that back.
Flip it round and imagine placing that underneath your horseshoe, leaving a little gap between the croissant and his nose. Then add a couple of little teeth and a tongue, and we can move on to his arms and legs. Let's get some string, cut off four pieces, two bits for the arms and two bits for the legs. Position the arms with a bend in the arm down to about the bottom of his tummy. Then add in a couple of tiny loops for the fingers, before continuing the line of the arm up to the top. And repeat on the other side. His legs are slightly shorter, and we add a little curve to them so they are not completely straight lines. Then draw loops for the feet, take it back up to the top, and do the same with the other leg. Finally, we're going to add in some lines to the top of his head for the ears. Then we just erase those overlapping and crossing lines like so, and there you have it. Jake the dog. Who knew he had all that inside him? I'm going to draw Clarence, using objects and shapes from the world around me. These shapes could be anything from a bottle cap, to a rubber ring, or how about this bar of soap? It's all right, I haven't used it. Let's draw that shape. What else? Well, I know that Clarence is friends with everyone, so he probably has a big heart. And you know what? If I tilt my head just right, I can see it. Now is a good time to draw in the neckline, and what will be the top of his t-shirt. And then you can remove the line above. For his eyes, I'm going to use the buttons off my shirt. Yes, I am. Which look something like this, shading the middle so he has big round pupils. Just above and along his forehead, he has a wavy hairline, like the ocean. A bracket, or big C, for his cheek. Notice that the curve of this line is identical to his opposite cheek. Now a little cheeky smile, with some blunt vampire teeth. His nose is turned up like a little piggy. Wide and flat, getting slimmer at the top. We only draw the top part of this shape. Leave the bottom open, and instead just put in little air holes so he can breathe. Next, get a big bag of jelly beans, because they are delicious. But actually, while you're eating them, take a look at the shape and then draw in four as his arms and legs. Now, unless he's been working out a lot recently, we need to add in a little pot belly, which would be round and soft like my scrubby sponge here. So, starting from the middle of his body, I go around my sponge shape, looping back along the bottom of his body, before looping back up again to the middle on the other side. Now we just need to clean him up, taking away those messy inside lines we don't need. For instance, we can have his belly in front of his right arm so we can get rid of that inside line. Then rub out the bottom of our belly soap bar shape. And I'm going to have his left arm in front of his belly on the other side, meaning we can remove his belly line, as I won't see it through his arm. Not without X-ray specs or something. Wait, do I have X-ray specs? Because that would be cool. No. Okay then, feel a little bit sad now, but moving on. Delete the circles at the top of the legs, as we won't see those once we draw on the shorts. Draw in some little sausage fingers, and then the thumb pointing slightly away. And some little shoes for his feet. Now we draw in two sock lines. Leaving a little gap around the knees, we put two more lines in across the thigh for the leg of his shorts. One big one across his waist, and a smaller one at the top of his pot belly. A couple of sleeves, and there you have Clarence. Give it a go yourself, and tell me what you see. Today, I'm going to draw Gumball, using objects and shapes from the world around me. Like a toothbrush, or a chair. Ooh, that one will look good in my flat. It's also just right for our head. So use the outline for the head with a nice rounded edge. What's next? A dinghy. Okay. Off to the pool we go. What do you think we'll use that for? Well, point it to the sky so your friend falls out, and we can use them for his eyes. One, two. Big dinghy-shaped eyes with big dinghy-shaped pupils, but not quite as big. A flower. Well, a flower petal is perfect for his nose. And this shape slots in just under his eyes. Overlapping the eye, draw in the petal shape. Then add Gumball's little tooth sticking out underneath. It looks like an upside-down shark fin. Clean up the unwanted line and add the detail lines to his nose. For the ears, we need something pointy, just like the top of a pair of women's shoes. Perhaps you've got some. If you're a girl, we only need to use the pointed part on top. One, two. Then take a screw. You might have to ask your dad, or your mum if she likes DIY, and we use the screw for his body. Point it upwards just like the dinghy's, and that fixes in right under the middle of our chair. Just use the outline to create his body, with the bulge at the bottom for his little belly. Next, take a bone, if you can get it off the dog. Once again, turn it upright, slotting in the bottom half beneath the screw for his legs. Draw the outline, but this time add a line through the centre. Add two lines on each leg for the turn-ups on his trousers, and then two lines on each paw. No, you don't need a whole piano. It's what comes out of it that we want, the notes. Take the simplest one, a crotchet, and that will work for the arms. One will be hidden behind his body. Add those, and then tidy up the lines inside. Add whiskers. Three, and two. Well, he is a cat after all. Two eyebrows right at the top of his face. Two lines for his collar. Then it's onto his arms. Two lines on his paw, and then the cuff of his sweater. Mark the line of the cuff on the other arm. And finally, just so he isn't wearing an all-in-one suit, add the line for the top of his trousers. And then his little zip. And there we have Gumball. Today, I'm going to have a try at drawing a fish with legs called Darwin, using shapes and objects from the world around me. For instance, right in front of me, I have a computer monitor like this one here. So, what if I imagine I'm drawing round a smaller version? That's pretty good. But Darwin also has a chin that bubbles out about midway down his face on one side. Sort of like a rubber ring. So picture that looped around the bottom half of our TV. I'm gonna get this sort of shape. On the other side of his face, he has a little fin like a seashell. It loops around and has a couple of lines on top. Quickly clean out the messy inside lines now so we can start on his features. I'm thinking the shape jelly beans for the eyes, as they're tall and thin. Then I put a slightly smaller shaded area for the pupils. Give him a couple of little eyelashes, like so, and two thicker eyebrows. I'm going to have him smiling, so I'm going to draw in some cheeks. One either side of his face, like two little circular half moon shapes. Then I'm going to connect those with a smiley line, like so. Let's think for the legs. What do they look like? Well, they kind of look like golf clubs, don't you think? No, I only need two. Drawing a line down the middle, I will draw one golf club shape pointing to the left, and then, using the same centre line, draw another pointing out the opposite way. Add a few little extra details on his shoes, like the lines on the toes, little circular dots about the ankle, and the strips for his socks. And, wait, something is still missing. Hands. Well, fins would be more accurate. I'm going to put those either side of his legs. And there you have Darwin. All ready to shade and colour as you like. Give it a go yourself. And tell me what you see. When I draw certain characters, I like to break them down into smaller sections and shapes in my head. Look what happens when I take a clover leaf and lay it over a cloud from the sky. It's starting to look like someone already, right?
Muriel from Courage!
No, it's not Muriel. It's Steven Universe. Okay, maybe I need to add a few more details first. Like, an ear, which is sort of a backwards D shape. Then I'm going to swing that line round again for a little sideburn and back round to the middle of his forehead. Then remove the line we originally had. For the eyes, I'm going to use this jelly bean shape. Big for the eyes. And then turn that shape on its side and draw smaller ones for his eyebrows. Shading in those and then adding some pupils. His nose is a triangle shape like the roof of your house flipped on its side. And his nostrils are just two little straight lines. Give him a nice big smile, and that looks like Stephen, right? Stephen's body and legs are equal to the size of his head, and I'm going to use this padlock shape as a structure for his body. First, I'm going to draw a line down the middle of the left-hand side lock. This will be his stomach. When you get to the middle line of the lock, cut in a little, then straight down for his leg. Now his feet are like a door wedge, down almost to a point, then boxed off at the toe. When drawing the line to the heel, keep in mind where the centre of the lock is, as you want to keep a gap between his legs. Then draw his inner leg lines and connect them in the middle. On the opposite side, using that curve of the lock shape for his arm, draw another line alongside this one to show where the top of his inner arm will be. Again, when we get near the middle lock line, where his waist is, you can draw in some hands. A little roof shape on its side again for his thumb, followed by a few cloud bumps for his fingers. Add a couple of fingers in on the other side like this, staying inside our padlock shape. For his right leg, draw a straight line down from the middle of his hand. Add a little point for his foot before boxing off the toe to the bottom of our lock. Time to remove that lock. Across the chest, all around the bottom, the middle line, but just on the hands, we want to keep the waistline, and we don't need that one on his face. Now add in some more defining details. Two little lines for the flies on his jeans, sleeves for his t-shirt, and two band lines across his ankle for his turn-ups. Now the toe part of his flip-flops. big arch for the smaller toes and one smaller one for the big toe. A line across the sole and then block off 5 toes. Then similar on the other foot. Finally, saving the best for last, the star. And there you have it, Steven Universe, all ready to shape and colour as you like. Using shapes and objects from the world around us, what do you think we would need to draw Mordecai from regular show? First, take an egg. Turn it on its side and we can use this as Mordecai's head. Next, we need to add his beak. A hair clip will work for this. Use the midpoint of the egg as the guideline and add the beak on the left side of the head as we look at it. Heads up, beach ball coming in. 2 balls can be used for his eyes. Draw them sitting on top of the beak. 1 will overlap the edge of his face. Then add 2 dots for his pupils. It's a shark. We just want to use the fin that rises up above the water though. We will need 2, but they vary in size. Large one at the front, little one behind. Draw the large fin from the top edge of the eye on the left as we look at him. Then add the small one, starting from the end point of the big one. Draw the detail line on his face, like this. And then add another across. Add a little hump on top of his beak, between his eyes. Then clean up all the unwanted lines. Can you smell that? Sausages! 1 will work perfectly for the body. Draw that upright from beneath the middle of his head. Now what about his wings? I was going to call them arms, but he is a blue jay, so we'll go with wings. They are a very weird shape. Imagine your school tie with 4 feather-like pointed fingers. Draw a straight line roughly through the middle of his body, starting just below his neck. Add the fingers, and then curve the line back up to his head. The other wing is partially hidden by his body. Use string for the legs. They will be the same length as his body, so mark his body 1, and then the same beneath 2. Draw his legs long and thin. For his feet, we need a certain shape, and you can use your fingers to create it. It's the shape you make when you play rock, paper, scissors. Add some feathers on his back, clean up the unwanted lines, and add some stripe lines to the feathers and on his wings. A line at the top of his chest, and then loads of lines down both legs. And there we have Mordecai. Oh! When I'm walking around, or even sitting at my desk, I often see things that I can use when drawing a certain character. Take Rigby from regular show. I have a rubber on my desk that is the same shape as his body. And if I look at his nose, the first thing that pops into your mind is an ice cream cone. If you just extend the bottom line of the cone a little and loop it back round, we have his mouth. Jot in a couple of little teeth and a line in there for the tongue. I wouldn't recommend putting this next item on your ice cream, but I'm going to put a little olive shape on the end point of our cone for his nose. Now I'm going to remove this line at the top of our cone to make room for his eyes, which are like the wheels on your dad's car, only a lot smaller. First, we draw the outer line of the tyres, like this. Then I want you to remove the line in between, so it kind of looks like you're looking through binoculars. Then inside each eye, draw another circle, and then dot the middle for his pupils. Okay, moving to the top of the head, I'm going to draw in 4 loose spike shapes for his hair. Not straight up, but leaning forward a little bit, like over the course of the day his hair's gone a little floppy. Then going back to that olive shape we used for the nose, but a little bit bigger this time, I'm going to draw in a couple of ears, pointing out in opposite directions, and add a line up through the middle. His legs will be about a quarter of the length of his body and look like a couple of sausages. And his feet are flat with 3 pointy toes, like on your kitchen fork. I'm going to put in a little twig-like arm on his side, starting just a little over halfway up his body, making sure I leave enough room for not one, not two, not three, but four little fingers. And if you want, put a couple of fingers visible on the other side as well. I'm going to put his worm-like tail in now, which is quite wide and curves out and then in again all the way up above his head. And then add in a few stripes all the way along. Remove that line on his head, because I don't need that anymore. And now, being really careful, I'm going to put that line that goes from the point of his nose all the way round his mouth, down to the bottom of his body. And that's it. Rigby. All ready to be coloured and shaded, however you want. Today, we're going to draw Uncle Grandpa. And we can use things from the world around us to help us do so. Take a really chunky bolt, like in Frankenstein's neck. Ooh, the outline will work as his head. Next, take a chocolate chip cookie, or in this case two, for his eyes. I'm hungry now. Ooh, I love a good cookie. Draw the two eyes at the top of the head, joining them in the middle. Add two dots for the pupils, and two eyebrows above the eyes. He's awake now. Good morning. Now, what about his nose? Ah, I know. Take a rugby ball. It's a bit like an egg, isn't it? Well, I know some of you don't play rugby. Making the shape the same width as his eyes, draw it below, but just overlapping them. Then clean up the unwanted lines inside.
You've got mail.
Mail? How do you think that will help us? Well, if we remove the edges, we get the perfect shape for Uncle Grandpa's moustache. And that slots in right under his nose. But his moustache isn't straight, is it? So using this shape, we need to imagine that it is made of clouds and follow it all the way round. Looks like it's smiling, doesn't it? Pop in his wonky tooth, and he is. Add the dimple in his chin to finish off his face. Just tidy up the unwanted lines running through his moustache. What's next? Pile of beans. Ooh, are they magic? Ooh, is there a giant? Well, one is just the right shape for his ear. And then flip it for the other one. We will use the top of his eyes as the guideline for the top of his ears. But we need some detail. So imagine he has snakes in them. And they mirror each other. Let's now move on to his body. Is Uncle Grandpa in good shape? Not the last time I saw him. So we'll need something big and round for that body then. Ah, a football. Perfect. Use the sides of his big chin as our guidelines to mark the width of his body. And the top part of the ball will be under his chin. A couple of bits of trusty string will work for the arms. Use the bottom of the body as our guideline. Draw the arms. Then add the cuffs of his gloves. Then, we add his hands. They look like woolly mittens to start. Then we add two lines to each for his fingers. Stop! The cones are out, so go no further. Only kidding. We can use these for his legs, but they'll need to be upside down, so two of those with the bases hidden behind his belly. They will be the same size as his body, so we mark that guide, and then the same again for his legs. One, two. You'll need to add a little kink about halfway down so that his legs can bend. Couple of jelly beans for those feet of his. Then we can start adding some detail lines. First, one across his tummy, just above halfway. Two little buttons, and then add the straps of his dungarees. Collar and buttons on his shirt. And you thought you were only drawing one character, didn't you? Well, we can't forget belly bag, can we? A computer mouse would work well here. So draw this slightly to the left on his belly as we look at it. Then add the straps, and then the zip. Add the lines on his legs, at the top for his shorts, and at the bottom for his socks. And to make sure he can bend them, we'll add those knees. Clean up all the unwanted lines. And Uncle Grandpa is ready for adventure! Oh, wait. I think we've forgotten something. Well, we can use some lift-off so Uncle Grandpa could get his. We can use the rocket top as his hat. Imagine he's got a pointy bump on his head. And don't forget to add his little helicopter blades. And now, he's definitely ready.
Here's how to draw Blossom.
Let's do this!
Start with a line for her hairline. She has three small triangles in her fringe. I'll draw her looking to her left. Below the centre triangle, I'll draw two frowning eyebrows, then two long lines for her eyes. In each eye, draw two bean-shaped pupils, then two longer lines for her irises. Give her a small, happy smile.
That was awesome!
Yay!
At the top of her head, we'll draw a knot. From the centre, draw two bunny-shaped ears. That's the bow done. She's the leader of the group, so I'll have her standing tall. Her left leg is rounded like this. Her dress is a flared square. Follow the dress line when drawing her right leg. It's a little longer than the left one.
All right, girls, time to level up!
Draw a line on each leg and fill her shoes in black. Add a stripe on her dress. Use a small oval for her right arm. Halfway from under her left eye, draw a kidney bean shape for a hooked arm. Draw a wavy diagonal line away from her head to knee level. Join that back to her leg. Add a curved line on her right. Then a little detail for her hair. Blossom's colour is pink. Colour in her eyes. Then her dress. Her bow in red. Black for her pupils. Finally, fill in her hair with orange. There you have it. That's how you draw Blossom. We're going to learn how to draw Bubbles.
Hi, my name is Bubbles.
Start with a circle. Draw a rounded wave-like fringe like this. Then move on to her hair ties. Draw one small circle on the right, slightly overlapping her head.
This was the best day ever!
Bubbles wears her hair in bunches. Draw a short, bushy foxtail with a pointed end. Draw the same on the other side. Now the eyes. Under the fringe, near the centre, draw a sweeping round line. Then a smaller curved line for her left eye. In the middle, draw two peanut-sized ovals for pupils, plus two longer rounded lines for each iris. She has a U-shaped smile.
OMG! Yes!
The Powerpuff Girls can fly, so I'll draw Bubbles in a flying pose. In the middle of the left side, draw a drumstick-shaped arm. Draw the same on the right.
Project!
When they fly, one leg is tucked up like this. Draw a pebble-shaped circle. Halve it for her shoe. Extend her leg. Add a line on the end for the other shoe. Draw a black stripe in the middle of her dress. Bubbles' signature colour is blue, so I'm going to start colouring in her irises. Her dress is also blue, just like her hair ties. Choose black to fill in her eyes. Bubbles has blonde hair. Colour all of her hair in yellow. This completes the look for Bubbles. Let's draw Buttercup from the Powerpuff Girls.
This is gonna be fun.
All the girls have round heads like a ball, so start by drawing a circle. For her hair, draw a line a third of the way from the top of the circle. Use this line to figure out where her features will be. Pop in a triangle for her fringe. Follow the triangle edge. Add grumpy brows like this. Under her brows, draw two wide fly-shaped eyes. Her hair pokes out on either side like shark fins. Let's have her looking up. In the left corner of each eye, draw two semicircles for the iris and pupils. Add a little smile. Buttercup has these spiky hairs on the back of the head. It matches her personality because she's a bit of a tomboy.
Don't call me princess!
Imagine a capital letter A. Draw this under her chin, adding a line in the middle, dividing her body and legs. Pop a black stripe in the centre of her dress and black shoes. Then draw two jelly bean shapes for her arms. Buttercup's signature colour is, of course, green. pick this colour in your palette, then fill in her dress. She has the same colour eyes too. Use black for her pupils and hair. Follow the lines that you've drawn before when you're colouring in the top and sides of her hair. Don't forget the spiky hairs too. And that's how you draw Buttercup. Let's draw Mojo Jojo.
It is me. No introduction necessary.
Start by drawing a rounded bar of soap. Draw a line a third from the bottom. In the centre of this line, draw a triangle for his hairline. Shape his cheekbones and chin like a three-leaf clover. Now, imagine half an orange. Draw two angled semicircles for his eyes. Add a wiggly nose and a frowning mouth with jagged shark teeth. In line with his eyes, draw two little ears with squiggles inside. At the base of his helmet, draw a pointed crown. Let's add three ovals. Draw a dot in each eye.
Mojo has much crying to do.
Now for his outfit. In line with the middle of his ears, draw an envelope shape. This will be your handy guideline. From the left corner, draw a curved bib to the right shoulder. This is the top of his cape. Add a rectangular waist, followed by a trapeze shape for his tunic. Then two pointed boots. For his arms, draw two angel wings with straight ends. Mojo always wears gloves. At the end of the left arm, add a claw-like hand, followed by two lines for his fingers. Draw the same on the other side. On the right, lengthen his trailing cape. Erase your guidelines on his bib, fingers, and chin. Now, time for some colour. Mojo has black fur. Colour in his cheeks and hairline. Make the edges ragged so it looks more like hair. Colour both his arms in black. The jagged detail on his arms too. His colours are green and purple. Use green for his face and ears. Then use light pink for both of his eyes. Now move on to his helmet. Colour the crown in grey. Use lilac for the jewels and the four wavy stripes on his helmet. Leave a gap between each stripe.
The hat, the evil laugh, the winning smile.
Use dark purple for his bib and tunic. And it's also dark purple for his train. Use light purple for the inside of his cape. keep his gloves, belt and boots white. And there you have it. Mojo Jojo.